Today at IFA, LG announced the new LG V30. It has a similar design to the LG G6, although it has even smaller bezels at 7.9 for both the top and the bottom, whereas with the LG G6, it had an 8.9 mm top bezel and a 10.5 mm bottom bezel. The side bezels are the same size, although the sides are now curved, with a slight curve on the display. The LG V30 is only slightly larger than the LG G6 and is much smaller than the LG V20. The LG logo has been removed from the bottom bezel to help make it smaller. The back is still glass, but it is now shinier and it has new colors. The camera module has been made smaller and the flash is no longer inside of the camera module. The LG V30 is actually thinner and lighter than the G6, but unfortunately, this means that the camera protrudes again. The LG V30 has a 6-inch full vision OLED display. It's not as wide as the 5.7-inch one on the LG V20 because of the new 9:18 aspect ratio, but it is still a lot bigger. It also has a screen-to-body ratio of 81.21%, which is higher than the LG G6's because of the bigger screen and smaller bezels. It has the same 1440 by 2880 display resolution as the LG G6. The main feature of the LG V30 is a new camera. The main camera now has an f1.6 aperture, which is the widest on any phone, and the wide-angle lens has also gotten a wider aperture of f1.9 instead of f2.4 like it was on the G6. The camera is also 16 megapixels like the V20, not 13 megapixels like the G6. However, the wide-angle one is 13 megapixels. The front-facing camera is the same one as on the G6, which is a wide-angle 5-megapixel camera. In camera software, there are now some new filters that they have built into the camera app. There is also a feature called Point Zoom, where you can tap on a certain place in the display and zoom in on that part instead of having to zoom in on the center. And you can also import manual settings with a feature called Graphy, and it will suggest different settings if it doesn't think that these would be best for the specific condition. The LG V30 comes with a Snapdragon 835 and 4 GB of RAM. It has 64 GB of storage, but there will also be a V30 Plus exclusive to South Korea with 128 GB of storage. The LG V30, like the LG G6, has a 3,300 mAh, which is bigger than the V20's 3,200 mAh. However, it also does not have a removable battery like the V20. The LG V30 has a 32-bit quad DAC on all models, and it also supports Bluetooth 5.0. The LG V30 does not have a second display like the LG V20, but it does have a floating bar built into the operating system, which does the same thing as the secondary display, although it is now in the middle of the OLED display. However, in the always-on display, it is in the same location as it was before on top of the display and can be used for quick tools and notifications. The LG V30 has IP68 water and dust resistance, just like the LG G6, as well as wireless charging on all models. The LG V30 will be coming out on September 21st.